Just had an absolute cherry 26BH J-Flight come in here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Little no-slide 5,100-pound bunkhouse. Jayco makes kind of an upscale version of this floor plan than a more basic version. This is the upscale version, the full-blown J-Flight, as opposed to the SLX. It's about 300 pounds heavier, but it's got a lot more equipment for it. I'm gonna try to point some of that out as we go. And if at any point you wanna see if we still have this in stock or what we're asking, if you're just on YouTube, I leave you a link in the video description down here that says check for price or availability. Or at the end of the video, some links will pop up that you can click on. So hang tight and you can catch that then too. This actually is coming to us from Missouri. Older fella owned this. I haven't got the whole story yet, but as far as I can tell, it sounds like it was a simple, basic camper. We're going to do some grandkid camping, and the grandkids aren't with us quite as much as we expected, so we swapped up to a big triple slide couple's fifth wheel. So, sorry, grandkids. Grandpa and Grandma are going camping, man. I tell you, impeccably kept. I didn't realize what year it was. I didn't realize it was as old as it is because it looks like it's only maybe two seasons old, if that. Previous owner also added a lot of 110 powered LED lighting inside and just did a bang up job of doing it cleanly. And it's something, if you didn't want it there, it could be removed without like leaving scars on the trailer. Just did a great job. Looks like also upgraded to a power tongue jack from the standard manual tongue jack that would have come on these as well. Overall, I just, you know, there's tiny signs of normal use, but it's all here. It's all here in great shape. Outside utility shower to hose off the grandkids. These bumper caps over time have a way of wiggling out. So it looks like he came up with a nice little solution to keep his hose and things down in the tube. This is a person who knew what they were doing. There's no Carfax for campers, so my job is I get to play CSI for campers. Looking at this as though it were a crime scene, this is a professional, guys. This is done by someone who knows exactly what they're doing. It's a simple camper, but well equipped. One of my favorite parts about the J-Flight series by Jayco is that they're extra tall inside. They have a 6'9 interior height instead of 6'6, which is industry standard. And that's one of the reasons I personally go Jayco. And what's funny is this is the exact floor plan I go camping in. The full-blown J-Flight, though, we've got a wider entry door. It's got the bigger 30-inch entry door as opposed to a more common 26-inch. The full-blown J-Flight, you gain extra storage overhead as opposed to its little brother, the SLX. That's where all this is coming over here. So let me back up a step here. It's everything you need, nothing you don't. No slides, but you're not paying and you're not towing the weight of that slide out. In the full-blown J-Flight, we get the nice raised panel doors as opposed to just flat panel. And this is where you can start to see the extra LED lighting that they added. And again, this is 110 powered, meaning you have to be plugged in to park power. Batteries aren't going to operate that. But you have just got an obscene amount of very nice lighting in here all the way through. And they even wired properly, I mean professionally wired switches. I'll have to see if this guy was an electrician or something, because this work is done so cleanly and so well. It's just fantastic. The only, and I mean this is just the tiniest thing, if I'm going to call it a blemish, is you can see that they once had a flat screen mounted up here on a swing arm flat mount that has since been removed. But whatever, you're probably going to put a TV up there yourself and you'd never know it was there anyway. At least you know right where to tap into to hit the stud. You know, all that was done well here. Good drawers, cabinet space. You know, one of the things I like about going camping in this exact floor plan, basically, is it has a shocking amount of storage for a small-ish trailer, you know. The extra overhead height also means we get extra storage space because the cabinets are taller. Notice too, central air, we also have central heat. It heats up quickly. Whenever I've woken up a few times when I wasn't quite watching the weather forecast and, it's a little chilly in here. I can walk over, I can hit the furnace and in 5 minutes it feels, I mean, noticeably warm, comfortable, all that. This was also made right before the big double bunkhouse boom. And this is actually the thing that made me realize it is a couple years older than I realized. Normally,
in today's market, you walk back here and you've got the double lower bunk and then the double upper bunk. But this old Jack and Jill style gives you that extra cabinet storage right there, and there's no such thing as too much storage. This has a split bath back here, and when this concept first came out, it was kind of not well received. People felt weird about the fact that the sink was in the hallway, but what they realized is that you can have one of the kiddos here getting their teeth brushed or washing their hands while someone else is using the potty or you're taking a shower. And again, one of my favorite parts of this is that it does have that taller interior height. This is the reason I went J-Flight, because I could stand in the shower of a simple level bunkhouse camper. And just, I mean, you know, you can see the way that he ran the conduit for all the wiring and everything that they added. They didn't just staple stuff to cabinets, guys. This was extremely well done. You wish more used RVs were kept this nice. You know, the cabinets are free of blemishes, nothing's scuffed. The upholstery, I mean, this camper was used, but the upholstery is just not all, you know, broken down and worn down. Part of that is due to the fact that Jayco's do have a little thicker, higher grade, you know, memory foam in their furniture. But the fact remains, it hasn't worn through. Like, you don't see where the fabrics are worn out. And now your sofa's right here, because they obviously had a TV on that wall. This sofa directly across from that TV, this is where they probably spent most of their time. And you can see that it's not all worn down and frayed. Used, not abused. Big, big difference. Pretty simple walk around front bed, though you are still maintaining the full overhead storage cabinet. But a lot of people look at that and go, oh god, it's got that head knocker cabinet. Remember, the J-Flight's taller. That cabinet's up higher. You're not going to bash your head on that. I can sit with my butt on that bed and sit straight up, and even as tall as I am, I can't hit my head on that. This is not going to last long. Someone's going to see this and be like, holy crap, how quick can I put a hold on this? Can you take my credit card right here? You know, this is not going to last long. So if you like what you see here, you like this layout, but this camper has to be gone, give us a call. Again, the more simple J-Flight SLX series, we order those like 20 at a time here at Haylett RV. And, you know, you can get pretty much like a used price tag on a new one of those and still maintain full warranty. But if you are the lucky one that gets a chance to take this home, jump on it sooner, not later. I guess the message I have for you guys is take all the time you need, but need all the time you take. Because if you want to look at this today and call tomorrow, remember that someone else could have looked at it yesterday and they could be calling today. That's my message here. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.